A B C D E F G H. I want A plus English. That's so much fun. English education for you and everyone. So come along. Learn some grammar. Learn a phrase. Learn something new every day. Learn the A plus way.It's time to start the show. Are you ready? Good buzz, here we go. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. I want A plus English.
Hello and welcome to A Plus English. I'm Mike.
I'm Chicklin.
And today, Chicklin, we're going to be doing an article about medicine and more at the pharmacy.
Oh.
Ooh, we should actually say medicine and so much more、at the pharmacy, because pharmacies these days seem to sell almost everything. Let's take a look, though, at our warm-up question, which is kind of about what we usually think of the things that we get at the pharmacy. Medicine. Here's our question. Do you often take medicine when you feel sick? And what do you take medicine for?
I do take medicine when I feel sick.
Okay.
All the time. I have actually a lot of over-the-counter meds at
home. Oh, really? Okay.
Yes. Even if, like, when I have this feeling that I'm going to be sick.
Oh, even before you feel
yeah,
sick,
yeah, I just you might take medicine in advance.
Wow, okay. All right. So even for something simple like a cold、
yeah.
or a headache, you'll always take your medicine.、
Mm-hmm. Especially when、okay. there's a performance coming up. I'm like,、
oh.
I can't be sick.
Oh, absolutely. Yes. If your sickness is going to affect your job or something important that you need to do, it's good to take your medicine. And I think also...When doctors give you medicine, especially things like antibiotics,、
mm-hmm.
it's important to take it, right?
Yeah.
You don't want to just sort
you
of
can't
stop
it.
In the middle. That's right. So, yeah, it is important to take medicine, especially when you feel sick or unwell, or even, as you said before, you feel a little bit sick. Just be careful、
mm-hmm.
with how much you take. That's always good advice. So let's check out our article. We're going to find out about medicine and so much more at the pharmacy. And we haven't even started to talk about shampoo. There's lots of shampoo there and so much more. Let's check it out.
Welcome to Picture Dictionary. Ear thermometer. Ointment. Bandage. Band-aid. Gauze. Pain patch. Pharmacist. Tablet. Capsule. Pill. Prescription.Hand sanitizer, rubbing alcohol, medical mask, eye drops.
Medicine and more at the pharmacy. Warm-up question. Do you often take medicine when you feel sick? What do you take medicine for?
Greg walks into a pharmacy. Vivian is working there.
Hello, can I help you?
Yes, I need to buy some medicine for my cold.
Sure, I can suggest some medications. These pills can help with colds.
Are they painkillers too? This cold is hurting my head.
Yes, they can help your head. You also don't need a prescription. These are over-the-counter drugs.
Great. I want these cough drops too.I hope these can make my throat better.
Sure, for the cold medicine, take one pill with water every 4 hours. Don't drive after you take it.
Okay, I'll stay home and rest. Thanks.
Word power.
Cold. Cold.Paul went to the doctor to get some medicine for his cold. Paul went to the doctor to get some medicine for his cold. Suggest, suggest. I suggest Tony's kitchen for dinner tonight. I suggest Tony's kitchen for dinner tonight. Hurt, hurt.Hurt, hurt, hurt. Winston fell off his bicycle and hurt his knee. Winston fell off his bicycle and hurt his knee. Rest, rest. I need to rest after I work hard all afternoon. I need to rest after I work hard all afternoon.
认识字汇
Medication, medication.
All right, so the article is actually in the form of a dialogue. I always like doing dialogues. It's kind of like a little play, a little scene from a TV show or something. And let's set it up. Let's get an idea of what's going on at the beginning of this dialogue. It says, Greg walks into the pharmacy. Vivian is working there. Okay, well, that's pretty simple. Greg is the customer at the pharmacy, and Vivian is one of the workers, one of the clerks.Or something, she'll probably help Greg out. We hope.
Yeah.
We hope she does.
Yeah. 所以一开始的情境是 Greg 他走进去药局，然后 Vivian 在药局工作。这边说一个 Vivian is working there， 指的就是现在进行式的用法。我们先进到今天的 Magic Box。
Magic Box。
哇，小丑女率领着我的校队总算呢要来进攻敌人的大本营了。我的同伴们呢内心惶恐。Are we going now? 我们现在就要出发了吗？没有错，还等什么呢？ Yes, we're going. 姐妹们，我们要出发啦。英文呢跟中文很不一样的一点呢，就是动词需要搭配不同时间来变化它的时态了。例如呢，过去时间呢就要搭配过去式，未来即将要做的呢就要搭配未来式。那么现在时间呢？哎，你可能已经学会了现在简单式哦。当我们要描述一个事实、一个状态，我们呢就可以使用现在简单式。那今天呢，再从哦现在简单式进阶一点点哦，就要来跟你分享现在进行式了。现在进行式呢，顾名思义就是现在正在进行当中的动作。比方说啊，我正在跟你讲话，或是呢我们正要出发。I am talking to you.We are going now. 这些呢都是现在进行式，当下正在进行的动作。现在进行式要怎么形成呢？首先呢，我们先要有主词，比方说呢，像是你呀、啊、我、他、Tom 还是 Peggy。再来呢，我们要有一个 be 动词。OK, I am, you are, she is, OK. 那再来呢，接下来哦，就是现在进行式的精髓了。我们呢就要搭配动词的现在分词。现在分词要怎么形成啊？非常简单呢，我们就可以在动词后面加上 ing 就可以啦。比方说呢 ,talk 就变成了 talking。Go 就变成了 going, OK? 这个变化呢当然也是有一些例外了，例如呢五月天这首歌恋爱 ,ing, 正在恋爱 ,love, OK, love, L-O-V-E, 我们呢就要去掉结尾的 e, 再加上呢 ,ing, loving, L-O-V-I-N-G。当我们遇到结尾哦是子音母音子音排列的字哦，例如 jog 慢跑这个字 j o g OK 子音母音子音，我们呢记得就要重复字尾 jogging j o g g i n g。所以呢整个句子 I am talking to you, we are going, Peggy is jogging, OK 这些呢就是现在进行式的句子啦。现在进行式呢也可以用在问句啦，例如 is Peggy jogging, 佩奇正在慢跑吗？ OK, 没有看到他哦。那 yes, no 的这个是非题呢，这个 yes, no 问句，我们呢就把 be 动词呢移到句首倒装就可以了。OK, is Peggy jogging? Yes, she is jogging. Or no, she is not jogging.否定呢我们就把 not 加在 be 动词后面。另外简答题呢我们就可以搭配疑问词来问问题了，例如呢 what are you doing now? 你现在在干嘛？以上呢就是我们现在进行式的用法，记得学起来好好活用咯。
Okay, so Greg is at the pharmacy, Vivian works there, and since Vivian is an employee or a workerAt the pharmacy, she meets or greets, I should say, Greg, in a very polite way. Hello, she says. Can I help you? Because she's thinking, you know, he's looking for something. It's a big store. Maybe he needs her help in finding it.
Yeah, 所以 Vivian 看到 Greg 走进来就说 Hello, 我可以帮助你什么吗
All right, so Greg says yes, yes, you can help me. Yes, he says, I need to buy some medicine for my cold. Oh, actually it probably would sound more like, yes, I need to buy some medicine for my cold. Because he's kind of sick, right? He's got a cold. Doesn't mean he's cold, of course. We'll get to that. He's a sick Greg, that's all.
Okay, 好了，我们看今天第一个单词 cold. Cold 就是感冒的意思，所以我们通常会说 to catch a cold 就是感冒。比如说 I'm feeling a little bit under the weather. I think I caught a cold. 我不太舒服，我应该是感冒了。那这个字呢，就像 Mike 老师刚刚有讲到，它可以指天气很冷，或者是有时候一个人蛮冷淡，用这个字也是可以。那如果很冷的话，我们可以说Put on a coat if you feel cold. 冷的话呢，就穿上大衣吧。那我们再看今天另外一个句子。Paul went to the doctor to get some medicine for his cold. Paul 呢，去看医生，然后拿一些药治疗他的感冒。
Okay, so Greg is sick. He has a cold and he's at the pharmacy hoping that he can find some good medicine.
Yeah, 因为 Greg 他其实就是说 Oh yes, 我就是要买一些感冒药嘛
Right, well Vivian of course she's happy to help him She says sure, yes, I can help you find that medicine for your cold And she says actually even more helpfully I can suggest some medication So she's not going to just point him to where in the store he can find the cold medicine She will suggest some medications too So that might help him find what he needsfind something good that can really help him and also get him out of the store back home resting as soon as possible. And she points to one specific type of medicine. She says these pills can help with colds. Okay, and there are actually different types of medicines for colds too, right?
Yeah.
If you're coughing or if your nose doesn't work, all that kind of stuff. So she knows that these pills, also she could say this medicine can help with colds. That would have the same meaning.
Yeah, 那我们先来看第二个单字 suggest. Suggest 有时有介绍或推荐的意思，所以我们通常怎么使用呢？我们都会用 suggest that， 然后某人再加上一个原形动词。比如说 ，Johnson suggests that we stay for the night， 代表 Johnson 建议我们晚上留下来。那这个字呢，它的名词是 suggestion， 就是有建议，也是建议的意思。所以如果你问别人有什么建议吗？你就可以说。Do you have any suggestions? 或者 any suggestions? 你有没有什么建议呢？马克文例句是 I suggest Tony's kitchen for dinner tonight. 哦、oh, ，Tony's kitchen 是一间餐厅的名字嘛，所以意思就是说我今晚呢推荐我们去东尼厨房吃饭。所以 medication 刚刚出现这个字，它就是药或药物。所以 Vivian 就说 ，Of course I can help you， 没问题，我可以帮你，我可以推荐一些药物，这些都是可以治疗感冒的药哦。
Okay, and we often, actually often use that word medication and medicine in kind of the same way, right? I'm taking a medication for this or I'm taking medicine for this. You can use them in basically the same way. So looking at this medication, this medicine, Greg is probably looking at the box and reading what's on it. He says, are they painkillers too? So he's wondering if this medicine will not only help him with the cold that he has,but also with the pain that he feels. Maybe he's got a headache, maybe his throat hurts from coughing a lot or something like that. Often when we're sick, when we're hurt, our body is sore or hurts in some way, and a painkiller can help you just feel less pain, and that can help you relax and rest and get better faster. As he says, this cold is hurting my head.Oh, sounds like he definitely has a headache. Sometimes when your nose doesn't work, right, you feel all this pressure in your head. And yeah, it can be really uncomfortable and it can definitely hurt, especially when you have a bad cold. Or have you ever been on an airplane with a cold like that?
I haven't been on a plane with a cold.
Oh, it hurts a lot because,
the pressure,
right? You know, when you're in the airplane, you have to pop your ears. Well, when everything in your head is all filled with your cold, it can actually hurt a lot. He would definitely need painkillers in that situation.
Oh, I know, but I heard that if you swallow your saliva, it helps.
On an airplane?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Oh, but you have to...Squeeze your nose
Squeeze your
while
nose.
You swallow your saliva.
Yeah.
It's going to alleviate.
That might be hard when you have a cold, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Interesting. Mm-hmm.
You can try that next time.
I will.
But I hope you don't get sick.
Exactly. I just don't want to be on a plane with a cold.
Yeah, so Greg 就说啊、oh, 所以他们也是止痛药嘛。我的头好痛啊。那这边说我们今天第三个字就是 hurt。Hurt 就是使什么疼痛啊，有受伤的意思。这边是个动词，所以其实我们有一个片语，我们蛮常用的 ，It doesn't hurt to do something， 代表做什么事情不会有什么坏处，或做什么事情是蛮明智的。比如说，如果人家叫你试一件事情，就说啊，试试看也不会怎么样啦。其实英文就是 It doesn't hurt to give it a try， 就代表试试看也不会怎么样，也可以试试看哦，那种感觉。那 hurt 这个字呢，也可以当形容词，代表受伤的或者伤心。所以比如说你问人家有没有受伤，就是 Are you hurt? 那我们再看一个句子， Winston fell off his bicycle and hurt his knee. Winston 他跌落他的脚踏车，然后伤了自己的膝盖。
Alright, so Greg is sick. His head hurts, he's got a cold, he needs a painkiller. Let's see if Vivian can help him find exactly the medication he needs. She says yes about this medication. She says yes, they can help your headRemember, Greg was complaining about his headache. His head really hurts from the cold. Well, don't worry. She says they can help your head and also help your pain, I would imagine. And then Vivian adds, you also don't need a prescription. Okay, that word prescription basically describes the type of medicine or what the doctor gives you. After you see the doctor, they'll write the prescription or a special type of medication or medicineon some paper, and that piece of paper, we would call that a prescription. You take that to a pharmacy and they'll give you the special medicine, the stuff they often have behind the, you know, the little counter. It's maybe locked up. It's stuff they can't just give out to anyone. They can't just sell to anyone. Basically, the prescription is the doctor's permission or the doctor's order for you to take this type of medicine, this prescription medicine. That's what we call it. And then Vivian goes on to say these, the ones she's talking about, the ones Greg is looking at, the medicine he's looking at, these are over-the-counter drugs. So that's the big difference. Prescription drugs, the doctor has to say, I want you to take this and give you a special piece of paper. Over-the-counter drugs, or sometimes just OTC drugs, those are the ones like cold medicine, headache medicine, things like that, that you can just go into the pharmacy and buy on your own. You don't need to see a doctor. And they're usually things you take for not so serious sicknesses and illnesses, things like headaches and colds and stuff like that.
Yeah, so Vivian 他就回答了 Greg, 他说是的，他是可以治疗头痛的、哦、而且你也不需要处方签，处方签英文就是 prescription, 这些都是成药，成药的英文就老师刚刚讲的 over-the-counter drugs.
That's right. Well, Greg is happy about this. He's thinking that this medicine should take care of most of his problems, his cold, his headache. That is very good news for him. So he says, great, okay. He's happy to hear this, and he's happy with what Vivian has suggested. Then he remembers one more thing he wants to buy. I want these cough drops, too. I hope these can make my throat better. Ah, so he probably has been coughing a lot too. His throat is red and sore and painful. So these cough drops, which are kind of like hard little candies, really.
Like a lozenge.
Yeah, a lozenge. Sometimes they're sweet, maybe mint or honey, lemon, something like that. It's good if your throat hurts from a cold, from singing too much, from talking too much, whatever the reason might be, cough drops, these small hard candies, you suck them, they make your throat feel better. And hopefully that will take care of one other minor problem that Greg has, also because of his cold, a sore throat. Wait, too much of that.
Yeah, so Greg just said, great, 太好了，我还要买喉片，因为
Then you start to sound like this.
喉咙不舒服啊。
Cough drop.
Yeah, so I think I'm going to get some cough drops for you.
I think
this.
That's probably a good idea. We have a lot of talking to do today.
所以还要买喉片，然后希望可以缓解他的喉咙痛。
Okay, so sure, Vivian says, yeah, cough drops, no problem. Everyone needs cough drops at some time when they're sick or for whatever reason. Just a long night at the KTV. I need some cough drops. Anyway, she says, sure, for the cold medicine, now she's giving him the instructions, how to take it, when to take it, that type of thing.For the cold medicine, take one pill with water every 4 hours. Okay, so one pill with water every 4 hours. let's say in a 12-hour day, you'll take 3 or 4 in each day. And then she says, this is good advice and important advice. Don't drive after you take it. Ah, so this medicine, like some cold medicines, might have something in it that will make you feel better, but also, yes, make you feel sleepy or do something like that. So don't drive after you take it. Don't fly an airplane. Don't go on a long bike ride. Don't do brain surgery. don't go up in a rocket ship. You know, things like that. Mm-hmm. Don't do things where you have to be very alert and paying attention and that kind of thing. You don't want to be sleepy when you're driving. So make sure you're at home somewhere safe. And don't be out on the road.
Yeah, no school.
Well, possibly, but also no riding a bike to school, too.
Yeah, 所以 Vivian 就说，当然了，所以感冒药的话怎么吃呢？每4个小时搭配水吃一颗，然后吃完药之后不要开车哦。
Yeah, and no e-sports competitions. You'll be really slow and you'll lose really fast.
That's true.
Anyways, Greg says, okay, all right, so he's ready. He's got everything he needs. He's got all the information he needs to take the medicine safely.He says, okay, I'll stay home and rest. Good plan. And then he adds, thanks. So yeah, he'll pay for it. Then he'll go home. And as he says, he will rest.
So rest, 我们下一个单字。Rest 就是休息或睡眠。那我们再看一个句子。If you're sick, go home and rest. 如果你感冒的话就回家休息吧。那这个字呢其实 rest 也可以当名词。那当名词的时候我们常常就会说 take a rest。你可以说 I've been working all day, I need to take a rest. 我已经工作一整天，我必须休息了。那我们再看一个句子 I need to rest after I work hard all afternoon. 整个下午努力工作之后呢，我需要休息一下。好啦，所以 Vivian 就问了 Greg 嘛，他就跟 Greg 说 OK, 你吃了这个药之后就不要开车哦。然后 Greg 就说好的嘞，我会在家休息，谢谢你啦。
Yes, we hope Greg gets home safely and feels better soon. All right, guys, well, we're almost done, but we do have a review time to do. So let's go and do that. We'll take our vocabulary medicine and then we'll be free to go too.
Review time.
All right, so for our review time today, we have our 4 words up there, and we're going to do a game of opposites.
Yay!
Or to give it the proper name, antonyms,which are those words that are opposites. Up, down, yes, no, expensive, cheap, things like that. So let's look at our words one more time. Cold, suggest, hurt, and rest. All right, so I'm going to give you a word that is the opposite of one of these words, or kind of in the general area of being the opposite of one of these words. We'll start simple, okay?
All right.
Okay, we're going to start simple, and I'm going to say work.
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 When you work for a long time, you feel like resting.
Energy. Yes, working is when you're using energy, when you're busy, when you're doing stuff.Resting is when you're not busy, you're not using energy, you're sitting on the sofa like a couch potato. All right, let's look at another opposite. Ooh, okay, how about this one? Order. Tell. Demand.
Demand. This is like you're trying to force someone to do something, right?
You will do this. You must do this. Do what I say.
It's definitely not hurt.
No, not hurt. Well, that might hurt your feelings, but no, it's not hurt. Order is not the opposite.
If you're making someone do something.
Kind of like that. Yeah, you're making them do it. You're ordering them. They have no choice.
So possibly is suggest, because this is like a milder way.
Yeah, well, suggest is like, why don't you? Or I think we should, or maybe, you know, you're not telling them, you're asking if they think that this, you know, if
might
they agree.
Work.
That's right. This is your opinion, but you're not making them follow your orders. Okay, and let's see the next one. Okay, this is a pretty good opposite. Heal.
Heal.
To heal.
To heal. When you get hurt, we need time to heal.
Right, yes.
Or if you have a broken heart.
Exactly.
Someone hurt your heart.
If someone hurts your heart, then...
you need time to heal.
Or if it's a movie, you'll meet another person who will immediately heal your heart. And you'll live happily ever after. Yes, to hurt is to cause pain or damage. To heal is to recover and get better from the pain or the damage. So there you go. I think we did pretty well. And we're about out of time. What's the opposite of cold?
Can we say hot? No.
Well, no, because that's the adjective. This is the sickness.
Cold. It's like healthy.
Healthy.
Not being sick.
I guess so. Yeah, the opposite of cold is healthy. Although that's not really kind of the same.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Well, that's why we skipped it. We're smart. We'll see you guys very, very soon with more great articles. Until then, stay well, take your medicine, and come on back sometime soon.
Welcome to Picture Dictionary. Ear thermometer. Ointment. Bandage. Band-aid. Gauze. Pain patch. Pharmacist. Tablet. Capsule. Pill. Prescription. Hand sanitizer. Rubbing alcohol. Medical mask. Eye drops.
Medicine and more at the pharmacy. Warm-up question. Do you often take medicine when you feel sick? What do you take medicine for?
Greg walks into a pharmacy. Vivian is working there.
Hello, can I help you?
Yes, I need to buy some medicine for my cold.
Sure, I can suggest some medications. These pills can help with colds.
Are they painkillers too? This cold is hurting my head.
Yes, they can help your head. You also don't need a prescription. These are over-the-counter drugs.
Great. I want these cough drops too. I hope these can make my throat better.
Sure, for the cold medicine, take one pill with water every 4 hours. Don't drive after you take it.
Okay, I'll stay home and rest. Thanks.
Word power.
Cold. Cold. Paul went to the doctor to get some medicine for his cold. Paul went to the doctor to get some medicine for his cold. Suggest. Suggest. I suggest Tony's kitchen for dinner tonight. I suggest Tony's kitchen for dinner tonight. Hurt. Hurt. Hurt, hurt, hurt. Winston fell off his bicycle and hurt his knee. Winston fell off his bicycle and hurt his knee. Rest, rest. I need to rest after I work hard all afternoon. I need to rest after I work hard all afternoon.
认识字汇。
Medication, medication.